Rockrintamalla kevään konserttitarjonta huipentuu tänä iltana, kun Helsingin jäähallissa esiintyy heavy-osaston tämän hetken kuumin nimikki, amerikkalainen Megadeth. Pitkän tien kulkenut yhtye on noussut raskaan rockin huipulle. Syksyllä ilmestynyttä viidettä levyä on myyty maailmalla lähes 4 miljoonaa kappaletta. Suosio ei kuitenkaan yhtyeen kitaristia huimaa.
Success is kind of a crazy thing. I mean, people think, oh, it's so great and it's so glamorous and all that, and it's really just a lot of hard work to keep it up, and as soon as you stop, it kind of falls. So I'm glad that I'm kind of a hard-working kind of guy.
What is it that makes metal music so popular these days? It's a new phenomenon.
I think metal is like an extension of rock and roll, or what rock and roll was in the 50s, you know. It's the young kids, the teenagers, and even people older than that. They're just getting out their aggression and having a good time. And it's all the same, you know. It's just youth-activated music, and youth are always going to want that kind of outlet, you know. And instead of turning to violence and, you know, crime and graffiti and things like that, you know, people really get a lot of their frustrations out of a Megadeth concert.
Megadethista voi syntyä varsin synkkä kuva jo yhtyeen väärinkirjoitetusta nimestä alkaen. Laulut ja niiden videototeutukset vain vahvistavat tätä vaikutelmaa.
To the layman, we might have a dark and gloomy image, but we are actually really quite positive people, and we're really not quite as gloomy as one might suspect.
So say, for example, the song, A Tout Le Monde, you're on the video, you've got people jumping in graves, and you're singing about death, and so what's the message behind it?
It's not really any message. I mean, if you listen to the lyrics, it's kind of like, give the flowers to somebody while they're still alive and not when they're dead. You know, you should treat people with respect and with kindness as they're alive, and don't wait until they're dead to give them a fantastic bouquet of flowers. They can't see it, you know. And that video, I mean, we're having a lot of problems with that in the United States right now because people can't see the humor and they can't see what we truly mean about it. There's a big ray of hope in that video, and it's about survival.
Megadethista sai hieman esimakkua jo eilen, kun Marty Friedman piti helsinkiläisklubilla klinikkaa, jossa orastavat kitaristit pääsivät hakemaan oppia ja kysymään kikkoja lähes kädestä pitäen.
I think you should always like play along with records and everything all the time, because if you ever eventually become a guitar player, you're going to be in a band, so you got to get used to playing with other people. You know, people who just sit around and solo all day by themselves, when they're in a band, they're in big trouble until it comes time for their solo, and then they do some kind of shit like that and everything's all right. But like when they're playing in the middle of a song, they're in big trouble.
How long have you played guitar?
About 17, 16 years.
Why?
I don't know, I guess to come to Finland.
What kind of music do you listen during your spare time, when you're not playing?
Classical music, mostly. I'm not really so much a guitar fan. I mean, to me, there are a lot of great guitar players out there, and there's so many and they're so good.
Yhdeksi esikuvaksi paljastui kuitenkin Jimi Hendrix, jonka tuotannosta Marty tarjosi Peter Lerhen avustamana pienen näytteen.
Thank you.
I just like to play guitar, you know, and any excuse to get up and play guitar is good enough for me. It's gone beyond just practicing, because I find that if I'm just practicing, it's not really the excitement. I did my practicing for many, many years, you know, and there's just something about finding out what the fans want to know that intrigues me about wanting to show it to them. So we play our concerts every night, people have questions, and sometimes it's totally off the wall, you know, and it's just, it's fun to find out what they want to know.
A few years ago, Dave Mustaine said that he'd be out of the business by the time he would be 35, and that's only a couple of years ahead. What's the plan today? Will Megadeth be around in the years to come?
We're planning to be. I mean, we may not be after Finland, you know, we may just break up and forget about it. You know, it could end tomorrow, but hopefully not. And I really doubt that it will. I mean, we're going strong right now, and, you know, God forbid anything bad happened to us. You know, we try to keep karma on our side and treat people the way we want to be treated. So we're getting along, and I hope that we're playing long after 35, because that's not too far away, believe me.